Yes, welcome. Today we are going to be learning approximation and estimation in mathematics. Approximation and what? Estimation. First, we are going to learn about fractions. About what?
Fractions.
We are going to learn about fractions. What are fractions, or what is a fraction? A fraction is a part of a whole expressed as a figure placed on top of another figure. Is that clear? A fraction is a part of a whole expressed as a figure placed on top of another figure. A figure placed on top of another what?
Figure.
This is a fraction. 5/7. A figure placed on top of another what?
Figure.
A fraction is a part of a whole expressed as a figure placed on top of another figure. 5/7. A figure at the top is known as the numerator. The figure at the top is known as the what?
Numerator.
And the figure below is known as what?
Denominator.
The figure on top is known as what?
Numerator.
And the figure below is known as what?
Denominator.
Examples of fractions are 2/3, 4/5, 5/9. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
That is what fractions are. Now, we have three types of fractions. We have what? Three types of fractions. Number one is what we call the proper fraction. Number one is what we call what?
Proper fraction.
Whenever the numerator is less than the denominator, we have what we call proper fraction. Is that clear?
Yes.
2/3. 2 is less than 3, isn't it?
Yes.
Give me another example of proper fraction.
1/2.
1/2 is a proper fraction. Another example.
5/6.
That's a proper fraction. Another example.
7/2.
No, 7/2 is not a proper fraction.
2/7.
These are proper fractions. Number two is what we call improper fraction. Improper what?
Fraction.
Improper what?
Fraction.
Improper fraction is when the denominator is less than the numerator. That is when the numerator is greater than the denominator. Example is 10/2. Give me another example of an improper fraction.
9/4.
That is an improper fraction because the numerator is bigger than the denominator. Another example.
8/6.
Another example.
7/2.
Good. These are improper fractions. Another type of fraction is what we call mixed fraction. What we call what?
Mixed fraction.
A mixed fraction is when we have a whole number. You understand?
Yeah.
Attached to a fraction. Example is 1/2. This is a mixed fraction. Because we have a whole number, then we have a fraction. Give me another example of a mixed fraction.
2/3.
2/3. Give me another example of a mixed fraction.
6/2/3.
Yes. So this is a mixed fraction. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
This is a mixed fraction. So these are the types of fractions we have. We say that fraction is simply a part of a whole that is expressed as a figure placed on top of what?
Another.
And the figure on top is known as what? Numerator. Whereas the one down is known as what?
Denominator.
Whenever the down, the up one is less than the down, we call it proper. But when the reverse is the case, we call it what?
Improper.
But when you have a whole number attached, we call it what? Mixed fraction. Is that clear?
Yes.
Now we're going to learn how to solve fractions and how to do simplification. We will learn how to do what? Solve fractions and do simplification. Solve fractions and do what? Simply what?
Simplification.
In doing simplification, we're going to learn about a mathematics procedure known as BODMAS. A mathematics procedure known as what?
BODMAS.
Very important. And in BODMAS, the B stands for what?
Bracket.
In BODMAS, the B stands for brackets. The O stands for what?
Open.
The D stands for what?
Division.
The M stands for what?
Multiplication.
The A stands for what?
Addition.
And the N stands for?
Subtraction.
The N stands for?
Subtraction.
Subtraction. So this is a mathematics procedure that you use in solving simplification. So we are going to take an example. Example number one. Simplify. Example number what? One. Simplify. Fivefold number 2/3. This fivefold number 2/3 is an example of what kind of fraction?
Mixed fraction.
Divided by 23 whole number 2/5. This 23 whole number 2/5 is an example of what fraction?
Mixed fraction.
Times 3 whole number 1/4. This 3 whole number 1/4 is the example of which kind of fraction?
Mixed fraction.
Minus 22. Example, simplify 5 whole number 2/3 divided by 23 whole number 2/5 times 3 whole number 1/4 minus 22. Simplify this. When you simplify, it means that you should put it in a simple fraction. Is that clear?
Yes.
And examples of a simple fractions are the proper fraction that we did, the improper fraction or the what? Mixed fraction. So simplify it and put it in one of those forms. Now using Bodmas is a mathematics procedure that says whenever you see something like this, that you should first of all solve the one that is in what?
Bracket.
Solve the one that is in what?
Bracket.
Which is this one. Then when you go into the one that is in bracket, that one that has off. You understand?
Yeah.
If you don't find off, solve the one that is what? Division. If you don't find it, solve the one that is what? Multiplication. Then addition and then what?
Subtraction.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Now, first of all, solve the one that is inside the bracket, isn't it?
Yeah.
So write this one down exactly the way it is, so that we can go to the bracket. We'll first of all solve everything here down before we start mixing up all the one. So now here we have no of, no division, so we'll talk about the, we'll simplify the mixed fractions first. You understand? So these are the mixed fractions. How do you simplify the mixed fraction? You say 5 times 23 plus 2. Is that clear? 5 times 23 plus what?
2.
What is 5 times 23 with your calculator?
176.
Yeah?
176.
Plus 2.
Yes. 176.
Everything.
Everything.
Okay, 5 times this plus 2, you have 117. All over what? 5. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Times 4 times 3 plus 1. 4 times 3 is 12 plus 1, 13. Isn't it?
Yes.
So we have 13 over what? 4, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Minus what? 22. That's the first solving. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
But we've not finished solving it out. Is it the most simple way that it is? It's not yet the most simple way. So we'll continue solving what is inside here. So we'll write down this 5 2/3 divided by
5.
What do we do now? The multiplication, and we have subtraction. Which one do we solve first?
Division.
Multiplication, isn't it?
Yes.
So 117 times 13. 117 times 13. One 117 times 13. 15 what?
1521.
1521. All over 5 times 4.
20.
Minus what? 22. Is that clear? That's what we have. Now what do we do to this now? We can now subtract, isn't it? So before you subtract, make sure you put 1 as the denominator of this one. Because 22 is the same thing as 22.